Look, the Sun is our only home star in this universe. But what if the friendliest star for life isn't like our Sun? Interestingly, maybe it is true. The night sky, a vast expanse filled with twinkling lights, has always captured human imagination. When we gaze upwards, we're looking at a tiny fraction of our Milky Way galaxy, which is home to an astonishing number of stars. Our galaxy is huge compared to other galaxies around us. Of course, except the Andromeda Galaxy. But other galaxies are really, really tiny when being put in front of the Milky Way. Astronomers estimate that our galaxy contains around 200 billion stars, each a potential harbor for planets and, perhaps, life. Amidst this cosmic sea, our Sun stands out in several remarkable ways. Despite the occasional spectacle of massive stars that dwarf our own, I mean, something like Polaris. It is 440% more massive than our Sun and 1,000 times more luminous. Not to mention the major stars in the Orion, none of them is comparable. But believe you or not, the Sun is actually more massive than over 85% of the stars in the Milky Way. This fact might seem surprising given the allure and notoriety of those behemoth stars. Yet, the majority of stars are much smaller and less massive than the Sun, quietly shining away in their own corners of the galaxy. In fact, it's merely the small stars that go unnoticed and, to be honest, hard to observe. Among these myriad smaller stars, there is a particularly intriguing class that has captured the attention of astronomers and astrobiologists alike. Known as K-type main-sequence stars or orange dwarfs, these stars possess unique characteristics that make them fascinating candidates in the search for extraterrestrial life. With their reddish hue and lower surface temperatures compared to the Sun, these stars offer stable environments that might be more conducive to the development of life on surrounding planets. I have done an animation video showing the overall style of development of an orange dwarf system in a not-so-scrupulous way before, which you can check out in the link in the description below.
After.
Okay. So how? What on earth makes these orange dwarfs more promising?
Wait a second, orange dwarfs are not on-
What in the universe makes these orange dwarfs more promising? K-type stars, also known as orange dwarfs, occupy a fascinating niche in the cosmic landscape. These stars, which have a spectral classification of K on the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram, are smaller and cooler than our Sun but larger and hotter than the numerous M-type red dwarfs. Here's a deeper look at what makes these stars so intriguing. K-type stars typically have between 0.5 and 0.8 times the mass of the Sun. Earlier I mentioned that Sun is more massive than 85% of the stars. In that 85%, M-type red dwarfs, the most common type of star in the Milky Way, making up about 65%. What about the rest 20%? You guessed it, K-type orange dwarfs. Their radii range from about 0.7 to 0.9 solar radii. This places them comfortably between the G-type stars, like our Sun, and the smaller, more common M-type red dwarfs. Of course, this also makes them rarely noticed, as red dwarfs have a series of interesting behaviors, while orange dwarfs aren't that dramatic. The orange dwarf moniker comes from their distinctive hue, which is more reddish-orange than the yellow-white appearance of the Sun. Their surface temperatures range from about 3,900 to 5,200 Kelvin, cooler than the Sun's 5,778 Kelvin but hotter than the M-type red dwarfs, which have temperatures as low as 2,500 Kelvin. Now we are entering the important part. One of the remarkable qualities of orange dwarfs is their long lifespan. These stars burn their fuel at a relatively slow rate, allowing them to shine for billions of years. They can't win red dwarfs though, but enough to put our Sun in the shade. In comparison to other stellar types like blue and white giants, K-type orange dwarfs have more stable energy output and a longer main sequence phase. This long lifespan gives ample time for the development and evolution of complex life forms on any orbiting planets. Orange dwarf stars exhibit a stable energy output, which is crucial for the sustaining of life. Unlike more massive stars that endure violent explosions or erratic fluctuations, orange dwarfs provide a steady and consistent energy supply. This stability allows for the creation of stable climatic conditions on exoplanets within their habitable zone, reducing the likelihood of drastic temperature variations that could impede the development and preservation of life. Another favorable characteristic of K-type orange dwarfs is their relatively wider habitable zone compared to M-type red dwarfs. The habitable zone, often referred to as the Goldilocks zone, is the range of orbits around a star where conditions are conducive to liquid water, a vital component for the emergence and sustainability of life as we know it. K-type orange dwarfs have a wider habitable zone due to their higher luminosity, which enables a greater number of planets to be located within this life-sustaining region. What's more of K-type orange dwarfs is their weaker stellar activities and gravitational effects compared to red dwarfs. Red dwarfs, despite their ubiquity in the galaxy, they are jerks, emitting stronger stellar flares and have more significant gravitational pulls. These factors can lead to high levels of radiation and tidal lock for planets in close proximity to red dwarfs, making them less conducive to supporting life. In contrast, K-type orange dwarfs have less intense stellar wind and gentler gravitational forces, reducing potential hazards to nearby planets and enhancing their chances of harboring habitable environments. So you see, those characteristics of K-type orange dwarfs make them highly suitable for supporting life on exoplanets within their habitable zones. Their long lifespans, stable energy outputs, wider habitable zones, and weaker solar wind and gravitational effects indicate a higher probability of sustaining conditions suitable for complex life forms. While the search for habitable exoplanets continues, the focus on K-type orange dwarfs remains an enticing prospect for future exploration and the search for extraterrestrial life. Thus, in the never-ending quest for habitable exoplanets, some scientists have turned their attention to orange dwarfs. A good thing is that orange dwarfs are common in the universe. In fact, some of them are directly our neighboring stars not far away. Located a mere 4.37 light-years away, Alpha Centauri B is the closest orange dwarf star to our solar system after the Sun and is part of a triple star system including Alpha Centauri A and Proxima Centauri. It has a planet too, though it's a boring hot gas giant. And approximately 11 light-years away, the Rance system is also a close neighbor as an orange dwarf star. It has one planet, also has giant. But there are more interesting systems in the farther space. For instance, Kepler-442 is an orange dwarf and 1,150 light-years away. It also has only one planet, but that planet sits in the middle of the habitable zone. Remember, being in the habitable zone does not guarantee habitability at all, but it is a crucial indicator. If that planet holds water and proper atmosphere, it would be extremely similar to Earth. The difference is that our Sun will run out its fuel in 5 billion years, while Kepler-442 might take as long as 40 billion years. Of course, Kepler-442 is relatively small, but even Alpha Centauri B, which is just 10% less massive than Sun, can live for 13 billion years. That's still 30% longer than our Sun.
So orange dwarf wins.
But hold on, every coin has two sides. As you can imagine, compared to Sun-like stars, orange dwarfs still share more features with red dwarfs. For instance, they still tend to gift tougher solar wind to their vulnerable planets, and that blows away liquid in atmosphere. Thankfully, planets are still possible to protect themselves as long as having a strong magnetic field to block those high-energy particles away. So in conclusion, there are two major advantages on K-type orange dwarfs compared to our G-type Sun. And one major disadvantage, but not a big problem.
But I shall say, the Sun is good enough.